So now we go one step further and we say, well, we could do a subspace iteration with m vectors if matrix A is m by m. In other words, we could try to compute all of the eigenvectors of matrix A simultaneously. How would that go? Well, we started by saying that we started with a matrix that was some random matrix, but really what we wanted was to start with a matrix that had mutually orthonormal columns, right? And what simpler matrix to start with than simply the identity? It has the desired mutually orthonormal columns. Okay? What we could then do is say, okay, in each iteration, simply do A times that matrix, and then compute its QR factorization and keep iterating. And then in the end, we could compute a diagonal matrix that comes from taking all of those eigenvectors and hitting them on the left and the right times our matrix A, which then in theory would give us an approximately diagonal matrix where we can read off what the eigenvalues are. Okay, and then we would have our spectral decomposition, right? Our spectral decomposition would be A is equal to V hat times lambda hat times V hat Hermitian transpose. There is an alternative way of formulating this that is actually kind of remarkable, and it's known as the QR algorithm. Okay, and it also says start with a matrix V equal to I. But now, in each iteration, take your matrix A, compute its QR factorization, and once you have its QR factorization, multiply R times Q, creating a new matrix A. This is no longer the same matrix as we started with. And then take this matrix Q and multiply it from the right times our original matrix V, or the V that we're now accumulating. And that becomes our next V. Now, a couple of observations. Notice that V here is really a whole bunch of unitary matrices multiplied together. So V itself is a unitary matrix. Now, here is the most remarkable thing. This V that we compute right here is exactly the V hat that we compute right here. So this is really subspace iteration in disguise. And this matrix A right here actually ends up being the matrix A hat, which we would have computed as V hat Hermitian A V hat had we done this in every iteration. This algorithm is known as the QR algorithm. It is really a way of reformulating subspace iteration, but it turns out that there's a huge advantage to formulating it this way as opposed to as the subspace iteration with m columns. We're going to ask you to do a homework exercise where, through mathematical induction, you prove the similarity or the equivalence of these two algorithms, and then we'll make some further comments about this algorithm.